Hello everyone, my name is Xin Hong. I'm a PhD student from the Institute of Computing Technology, Chinese Academy of Sciences. In this presentation, I will introduce you a new visual reasoning task called transformation-driven visual reasoning. Let's first see a picture and try to imagine how current computer vision tasks deal with this picture. Image classification may tell you this is a cat. Object detection further provides the location of the cat, and then in the captioning system, we will see a cat is looking down later. Are these tasks already enough for testing the ability of visual understanding? How about add another image? You may immediately understand the cat jumped down from the ladder. Yes, you can reason the transformation between states. What about machines? Therefore, our research question comes out: how is the ability of the machine to reason transformation? This question includes two aspects. On the one hand, we hope machines to do transformation reasoning. On the other hand, we want to comprehensively evaluate this ability to see whether there is a task satisfied our requirement. We review previous visual reasoning tasks. So, what is visual reasoning? Visual reasoning doesn't have a specific definition. Generally, it usually requires higher level visual understanding to answer questions or do reasoning. For example, visual question answering may ask complex questions about the relation between objects in the image. However, these kind of state-driven tasks are not able to model dynamics. Actually, in some visual reasoning tasks, transformation is one of the core problems. For example, in visual storytelling, you need to understand the transformation between images to write a consistent story, or you need to understand the dynamics before choosing the correct action in physical reasoning. However, with current settings, we have no idea how models reason transformation. Therefore, we define transformation-driven visual reasoning. In this task, given the initial state and the final state, the target is to infer the transformation, and without loss of generality, we define the transformation as a sequence of atomic transformations, and an atomic transformation is set to an attribute level change of an object. According to this definition, we construct a new dataset called trends built on CLEVR. Let's see how we ground the three elements of the atomic transformation in trends. Most attributes and values are inherited from CLEVR, except some additional position transformations. To represent an object simply, we also provide attributes of the initial state, so that an object in the image can be referred by its index. Trends includes three settings to test different levels of transformation reasoning. Basic is to test single-step transformation reasoning. Event is to test multiple-step transformation reasoning. View further tests the reasoning with view variations. You can find more examples in our project page, and the whole dataset has been released. To comprehensively measure the ability of transformation reasoning, we provide evaluation metrics from different perspectives for single-step and multi-step settings, respectively. We benchmark 6 initial models under the proposed TransNet framework. And we also build a testing system to collect human results. From the results of experiments, we find on BASIC, the performance gap between deep models and the human is small. However, on event, deep models are struggle to find all atomic transformations, especially when the length of the sequence is large. And it is also difficult to arrange atomic transformations with a feasible order to avoid violating rules such as no overlapping. On view, models are unable to be robust to view variations as well as humans. That's all about the presentation. If you are interested in the detail of TVR, please read our paper or visit our project page. Thank you for your watching.